What is going on, hockey fans? The regular season ends in just 1 week, and there was so much on the line Thursday. Dallas had a chance to celebrate their first Central Division title in 8 years. We'll get to the highlights from the Jets and the Stars in just a bit. Plus, these two guys are getting close to individual numbers that, you know, we haven't seen in a long time. Nikita Kucherov closing in on 100 apples, while Austin Matthews hunting for 70 goals. We'll update you on their chases. But there was no bigger game than the Red Wings and the Pens. It was a must-win for both teams in Pittsburgh.
If you're Detroit or Pittsburgh, you're worried about the start of the game, the first shift, the first period, and so on until the 60 minutes is done, and you try to get the result that you want. Stay in the moment and be as good as you can be every time you hit the ice. Play like it's the last game you're ever going to play. I mean, every little play is magnified 1,000 times over.
O'Connor finds it. Russ down low. Here's Crosby off the end. Apron of the net to Russ. Save Ryan loose. They poke it to the net. No signal. The Penguins are celebrating as if they may have scored. Drew O'Connor was in the vicinity. Pittsburgh's going back to their bench.
Goal. They're pointing net. They're pointing at center ice. It's a goal.
What a crazy start here.
What a crazy start. And once again, the Penguins get the first goal here of the hockey game. As it was loose. It's underlying, but it's loose.
Oh, yeah, now, great look there.
My real guys quick. The truck.
Yeah, great look there.
Stays in the Penguin zone for a moment, a near steal, and it was, and a safe. Oh.
They score! Raymond gets the goal, and it's 1-1, huge goal for Detroit.
Almost a mirror image shot. This one by DeBrincat from the same spot that Pittsburgh's first shot came from, and a rebound is tapped in by number 23.
In comes Letang, scores! Bang, bang, Chris Letang! And the Penguins go back in front late in the first.
What I love here, Chris Letang stopped it, knew it was rolling, and just hammered a rolling puck 5-hole. Didn't deft it off, didn't wait, didn't caress it, bam, just pounds it 5-hole. Penguins have a lead back.
Here comes Larkin. Raymond to break it, back pass, right in, he scores! What a play! Lucas Raymond has two, and we're tied at two with 14 seconds to go in the first period.
And what a move by Raymond on Nedeljkovic to tie this game like that.
Dylan Larkin getting the assist, his 500th career point.
There you go, Dylan.
Maybe something here as Russ comes in looking at front. Crosby scores! Crosby puts the Pens in front and ties Phil Esposito for 10th all-time in points in the National Hockey League.
Marcus Pedersen stood up by Seider, and Pedersen's lucky he wasn't called there. In comes Russ, scores!
Top shelf, Brian Rust!
The turnover by Marcus Pedersen. What a shot by Brian Rust.
Right circle, fired, scores! Patriots made it 4-3 with 36 seconds to go in the second. Another late, huge goal for the period for the Red Wings.
This Red Wing power play, ninth best in the NHL entering tonight. Pass knocked to center. Jeff Carter's got a step. He's got the puck shorthanded. Carter scores! Big Jeff Carter!
Turnover, gets to the loose puck. And how many times in Jeff Carter's career have we seen a goal exactly like that?
Lucas Raymond on it. All alone, Larkin. He scores! It's 5-4 with 7:04 to go.
Well, Pittsburgh's unhappy with the way this thing unfolded. Look at Larkin shaking his fist. We're in it, gang. We're still in this thing. Detroit has got to scratch out at least a point here.
You bet. Larkin giving chase. Larkin sends one right in. He scores! Whoa! Does everybody love Raymond now? Yes, they do. Wow. It's 5-5. Lucas Raymond has done it again. It's his first hat trick
since his NHL career began in October of 21. We'll go 3-on-3 for the biggest point of the season.
2-on-1, it's Larkin with Seider. Larkin gripping, ripping, save the Delkovic! Alex Nedeljkovic, a huge stop. What a save by Ned to Rob Larkin. Crosby's out there, he's got the puck. Carlson loads up. Shot, scores! Erik Karlsson, the hero! The Pittsburgh Penguins are back in a playoff spot with an OT winner. And Sidney Crosby has 1,000 assists to boot. What a moment!
We didn't play as smart in certain situations tonight, you know, and we talk a lot about managing the game and how important that is to winning. You know, your calculation of risk has to change depending on the score of the game, the time of the game, you know, situational play. And that's an important aspect of winning. And I don't think we checked that box as well tonight as we have. But we were able to find a way to get 2 points. I give the players a lot of credit for hanging in there and just sticking with it. You know, that could have sunk a lot of teams, and it didn't sink this group, and I'm proud of them for that.
I give our guys a ton of credit. You don't come back and get a point in this league with being down with 7 minutes left. The guys fought. You know, we had our look in overtime. We battled, gave ourselves a chance. I know it doesn't feel good right now, but there's still a path there.
What a crazy game of playoff implications. But yes, Sidney Crosby, a goal and 2 assists, reaches the 1,000 assist mark while also passing Phil Esposito for 10th on the all-time point list. Sits 50 points shy of Joe Sakic for 9th place. And we now welcome in Mike Kelly to break this one down. And Kells, it was a fun one in Pittsburgh. Erik Karlsson comes through with the game winner. And I'm all about journalism, so I'm going to ask you the hard-hitting question. Do you like game winners?
Love game winners, especially when they come from guys who almost cost their team the game, which was what Erik Karlsson did in this one. And look, this is Erik Karlsson. This is the Pittsburgh Penguins. This is the microcosm of their entire season. Mistakes and just good enough and pull it out. It's 5-3. There's 7 minutes left. He shoulder checks Dylan Larkin. He sees him there. I don't know why you're going behind the goal line. You leave the most prime scoring area open on the ice. And then 5 minutes left, you're up a goal. You're pinching, trying to keep a puck in the O zone. Odd man goes the other way, and now it's a tie game. Those are two brutal mistakes to make in the third period when you have a 2-goal lead and then a 1-goal lead. And that's why this game goes to overtime. But then the future Hall of Famer claps Bomb City and it's lights out, game over. Pittsburgh wins. This is the Penguins. It's what they do. They give up a ton of odd man rushes. They're not a perfect team. This is why they're fighting to get into the postseason. But they did do just enough to get a massive 2 points in this game.
Yeah, not perfect, but fun. All right, so the Red Wings get a big point as well, go to overtime. Lucas Raymond, and I'm, you know, before I say the next part, let's do more journalism here, hard-hitting questions. Do you like hats and do you like hat tricks? Because Lucas Raymond had a hat trick.
Love him. Love him. It was his first one since early in the season, and he stepped up in a big way for the Red Wings. And we heard their coach talk, Derek Lalonde, about the gutsy effort, this team coming back in this game. Lucas Raymond was a massive driver, and he's going to have to be, right? He's going to have to be that player, that goal scorer for the Detroit Red Wings. I give him a lot of credit, and he had a terrific game. He was their most dangerous offensive player in this game. The tricky thing now for the Red Wings, because they didn't get 2 points in this game, because Detroit got a point, because their only path into the playoffs is through the wild card, they're not getting in their own division, they need to sweep these games. They need all 6 points. And I've heard some people talk like, oh yeah, they finished the season against the Canadiens, back-to-back wins, look where Montreal is in the standings. If you think you're getting an easy game out of the Montreal Canadiens, good luck. I'm not betting on anybody to beat the Canadiens 2 in a row the way that that team's been playing. So these aren't going to be easy games. They need all 6 points.
Kel, sit tight. Word is that Kangles were your favorite hats back in the day. We have some highlights cut up. Caps, Sabres, roll it.
Capitals with 85 points. They're in it. They desperately need a victory. And, of course, it is a bit of a jammed runway in the Eastern Conference. Krebs comes up top. Clearly the Sabres cycling their forwards high in the zone. Scores!
number 9 makes it 1-0 Buffalo.
Benson gets his stick in there, deflects it home. The Sabres are up 1-0 here in the first.
Yeah, you talk about Washington being a desperate team here right now. Buffalo is showing it up there.
He looks up right away and finds Tage Thompson to center. In across the Capitals line. Thompson drops it. Layers here. Tuck scores! Layers. And Alex Tuck puts it in to put Buffalo up 2-0 with 7:23 to go in the second.
John Carlson. Headman pass. Pacioretty crossing over. On a feed to the slot. Score! McMichael!
And McMichael gives the Caps some life here. And the Caps are back in this one. It's 2-1.
He's taking back. It's McMichael. Cross ice there. Alexia fires. Lukanen made the save. Didn't control the rebound. It's sprinkled to the corner.
Back comes Connor Clifton. 3-on-2 on the entry on this side. Quinn walks it in. Holds it. Drags it through. Scores! The buddy Quinn. That's a beauty, baby. It's 3-1 Buffalo with 10:14 to go here in the third period.
Precious time now in this game. Joakim Harju. Along the boards, off of the linesman, played ahead to Cousins, to the empty cage. It is 4-4 Buffalo and 1 for Washington.
Icing on the cake here on home ice for Buffalo.
Long drive, score! From point position, it winds up in the back of the cage.
And it might have been the high slot tip, yeah, by Tom Wilson.
It won't be required much more for Buffalo.
Tempers are flaring here. With no sign left on the clock.
The Capitals are going to fall by the final count of 4-2. Buffalo, as they did a season ago, takes 2 of 3 from the Caps. And these two wins in April will and may loom very large when all is said and done in the Caps' playoff chase.
This is no different for us for as coaches. Like, this has been the way our team has gone all year. And if we get a couple goals there, and now we'll protect that lead. If we don't and we trail, now it becomes a challenge. And that's what you saw tonight. And there was a few, like, you saw some of the young mistakes from our group in this situation where there's some nerves come in. We can't get a puck out on the wall 4 times in a row. Like, this time of year, like, that just can't happen. Our group won't be deterred, and we will continue to play and do the things that we've done since we've been on the edge of elimination, it feels like, for 2 months.
Isles and Canadians, the main event for some Thursday night hockey here at UBS Arena as the Islanders continue to chase their berth in clinching a playoff spot.
Look out here, a breakaway for Suzuki. Varlamov kept it out, and Nelson clears it away. Varlamov, that's his first save of the hockey game.
Knows he's beat with the pad, and then just gets the stick out. What a great save that was by Varlamov.
Back to the line, Caulfield. One-timer coming up, they score! Jordan Harris lets it rip from the line. Montreal's fourth shot of the first period with 2:02 to go. Caulfield tees up Harris, sends a bit of a knuckler all the way down and pass for Varlamov, who can't even see it.
Uh-huh. Makes the pass open in front. Armia denied. Varlamov reaches out with the glove and a big time stop in the final minute. Glove down by Sezikis. Carried it over the line, got the pass for Barzal. Made the move, but Munson Bull made the save.
It's almost the first chance off the rush by the Islanders this whole game.
Now it's Engvall in the slot, scores! Oh, what a shot that was from Pierre Engvall to tie the score at 1.
Engvall gets those feet over, cross over, square it up. Get those shoulders pointing towards the net, Brendan, you can get a pretty good shot away. That's a huge goal for the Islanders.
Here we go, find it center, Gallagher. With J.G. Pageau, gloves are off. And of course, this goes back to the last meeting in January. And now Pageau gets the right hand going. And Gallagher puts him back down on the ice.
Here comes Engvall. Save Montembeau. Trying to go 5-hole, and Montembeau closed it off.
Off the far side, Caulfield gets a walk, and Semyon Varlamov, it's in. Varlamov made the save, but the puck trickles in over the line. And the Montreal Canadiens retake the 2-1.
Bullock in front. Pellick, the backhand just missed. Sezikis on a wraparound, scores! Casey Sezikis ties it in the third.
What
a big goal. The timing of it, you're not sitting and waiting for that goal in the final minutes of the game. You get it back right away. Now you got a chance to take this thing over with all this momentum.
Angles the puck, slides it for Palmieri.
He scores! Kyle Palmieri! The Islanders win it in overtime! Point number 89 in the standings.
Tonight, it's the Rod Gilbert Rain Team Mr. Ranger Award.
Adam Fox, everything he does is off the ice, fits with what Rod Gilbert was all about, and so deserving of the award.
Throws it past Gabriel Miller and gets to it. Connecting, caught by Miller, who then wipes out. Connecting turns with it, cross ice pass, the shot, they score! Ken York joins the rush, and beats Jonathan Quick. And the Flyers get the first one here in New York.
Perfect shot off the pipe and in, and the Flyers with the important first goal.
Yeah, cool move by Panarin to Lafreniere in front. Oh, Erickson with a save.
What a save to Rob Trocheck. Trocheck swings and misses. Lindgren shot a save. Batted at by Fox.
That didn't look like a struggling goaltender there, did it?
No.
With that save, that was a beauty with the glove. A
couple of great saves.
And so the two-man advantage continues.
A crisscross, down low Fox. Panarin shoots, score! Artemi Panarin! It's a power play goal to tie the game 1-1. His 47th goal of the season. He might get to 50. Power play is over. The shot toward the net by Fox went wide. Outside Fox again. Down low, Kako, they blew the whistle. What happened here?
That was the player that was coming out of the box. He took everything with him. Wires and headsets and everything.
Ryan Finley moves up with it. Hands off to Brink. Brink, back for Paling. They score! I have to check it at the line to see if it's onside, but the Flyers, for the moment, have a 2-1 lead on the tip in front.
Yeah, that's good. It's onside. Once he re-corrals it, his head's up. He's looking for Paling going into the net. Smiles on that Flyers bench once again.
A chance in transition for the Flyers. The pass to Paling. Yep, York goes to the net. Paling waits. Waits, holds, goes across to Konechny, who scores! Travis Konechny with his career-high 32nd goal as he beats Quick. And the Flyers have a 3-1 lead in New York. Gates has Hathaway with him. Gates with a puck. Cuts in front. The shot, he scores! Extends his point streak to 5 games, a career high, and makes it 4-1 Philadelphia.
And the Flyers can count down on a very satisfying win as they end their 8-game winless streak in style, convincingly knocking off the NHL leading Rangers 4-1.
A much-needed win there for the Flyers, and here's a look at our Eastern Conference playoff picture. The Penguins jump back up to the second wildcard spot. The Islanders grab a huge 2 points to remain in third in the Metro, and the Flyers stay in the mix, ending that 8-game winless streak against the New York Rangers. Kells is back in the race for that final spot in the East, man. It is tight. Your company, SportLogic, has updated the playoff odds, so how is it looking as we sit here right now?
New York Islanders, punch your ticket. It's looking really good. It's not 100% yet, but it's north of 90. That's I think they're in. Pittsburgh improved their odds with that win. Obviously, they're over 50% now. They were not coming into this game. Washington and Detroit hovering around 20%. And the Flyers, 10%. It's not great, but they're still in the mix. And the thing is, all the teams ahead of them have shown this season they are perfectly capable of dropping a couple games. So nobody's done yet, but I'm really leaning now towards certainly the Islanders and a little bit of Pittsburgh.
So Capitals lose in Buffalo. How bad of a loss is this for Washington?
Yeah, they had to have it. And you can say that about a lot of these teams we're talking about, right, Keith? Like, you got to have these games, and not everyone's going to, but you're playing the Buffalo Sabres, who are not a great team. They are really not a great defensive team, and you just couldn't really generate a ton of good looks offensively. And that to me is, if Washington misses, what I'm going to kind of remember this season for the Capitals is, you know, the power play is okay. The 5-on-5 scoring is not good. And there just aren't enough guys. There's not enough depth. You look at their even strength point leaders. John Carlson hit 30 points in this game. Coming into this game, they only had two guys with 30 points at even strength. So Charlie Lindgren has been unbelievable. And the biggest reason why they are where they are, he was okay in this game. And, you know, now they're in a tough spot.
Kells, watch this. So I'm just going to, yep. Yeah, there's a pulse. All right, so the Flyers still breathing barely, still kind of alive?
Kind of hanging in there, yeah. It's look, if they hadn't won this game, they wouldn't be. So I more than anything, like I don't think they're getting in more than anything because they've also got a game less than the other teams, but they showed up and played a great game. They outscored the Rangers 4-0 at even strength. They hung with a very good team in this game. It wasn't like the Rangers got goalie. Sam Harrison had a really good game. And this is the first time the Flyers have gotten a really good game from their goalie in a while. It's amazing how that'll add up for you in terms of getting wins. So I give them a lot of credit for the way they showed up in this game.
Yeah, I left my stethoscope at home. I know you didn't realize I was a doctor anyway.
Nah, you're alive.
Yeah, I'm alive. You're alive. We're all alive, and we got a lot more to do. Seriously, what a night it was in the NHL. When we get back, we shift our focus to the Western Conference, where the Stars had a chance to sew up the Central Division crown. Keep it locked right here. Welcome back to On the Fly, out to Dallas for the Stars and the Jets.
The math is simple for Dallas. No scoreboard watching necessary. Win and they're Central Division champs. But this game is huge for the Jets as well. They can catch Colorado with a win tonight for second place.
Fourth and final meeting of the season between these two teams gets underway. It should be a dandy tonight here in Dallas.
And then Stankoven gets shoved down by Logan Stanley. He almost has a foot advantage on the Stars rookie.
Scampering to the line. Nikolaj Ehlers. Stop. Net drive and a big stop by Ottinger off Monahan. What a read by the Jets and a fine save.
Throw swap. That was his innocent looking. Now in front, a chance for Swan to save on the rebound and the putback pass from Johnston. Play to the whistle.
And it's off the Foley, loose in front. Ottinger with a save. Backhander. Score. Nikolaj Ehlers with his 200th NHL goal. And it's 1-0 Winnipeg.
A grindy one at that for his 200th. Of his career, and this is a fantastic job, just having some desperation in your game.
Gives the Jets their first lead all season against the Stars.
Shutley again for Winnipeg, finding Appleton as the Jets threaten for another one. Shutley, Sandberg, score! Dylan Sandberg with a shot from the line. Gustafson was in.
And both goals for Winnipeg, they haven't been Picassos, and they usually aren't in these types of games because there's just not enough time or space to make those pretty plays.
On his 24th birthday, he's had himself a game. Joe Pavelski, great team. Tanev with room, shoots, good save by Rostov.
Who continues his night of perfection here in Dallas. Shot wristed wide, Sandberg, follow-up Scheifele. Centers, and Ottinger the right pad save on Connor. Final minute of the second period. Looking to get on the board. Off the post, and it is under Brossois. The shot from Harley from the left point redirected and skipped its way off the post and found under the netminder.
He's had a touch of fortune in his game tonight.
Dallas looking for something to light an offensive spark.
It's been a 15 of the last 18. Stankoven, quick shot and stopped by Brossois. Left his poked at it. Parchment cut back, teed it up, second, blocker save.
Stars trying to puncture the force field of Brossois so far in this one.
Haskinen will take it right in, shoots a rising rocket, passes out for it, blocked away by Appleton, will turn and find it, makes the pass, Connor, and Mark Shelby's got an empty net, and he scores.
A desperate defensive play in a desperately played game for Winnipeg.
And they come out with the win. They beat the Stars 3-0. Brossois with the shutout here in Dallas.
They put the celebration for Dallas on hold.
Exactly. The Jets spoil the Stars' chances to clinch the Central Division and have now won 5 straight games for the 3rd time this season. They've outscored opponents 20-10 and have allowed just 2 power play goals in 12 opportunities. Mike, they say defense wins championships. It also kind of gets your season rolling as you prepare for the postseason. Winnipeg's defense, they've been great lately.
No question. I mean, we're talking the 5-game win streak. Winnipeg, I don't know if you know this, Keith. People come up to me on the street a lot. You know what they say? They say, Mike, who do you like? Who's that sneaky team that you like for playoffs? And you know what I tell them? I say the Winnipeg Jets.
Yeah.
Because when this team plays within that play structure, they can beat anybody. The problem is when they get away from it, they can't beat anybody, it seems. So this is one of those games, this is one of those runs where they're in that, they're playing well. Dallas didn't really get a lot of good sniffs around the net. The way that Winnipeg back checks and tracks, on transition plays, the way they jam the middle up on cycle plays, their penalty kill, everything in this game was really top-notch. And Laurent Brossoit was really good as well. Now you imagine when Connor Hellebuck's in that net, the best goalie in the league this season in the playoffs, it gets even harder to score on this team. So we got a big one coming up Saturday, Jets in Denver against the Avalanche. See who maybe gets home ice advantage as we get set for the postseason, probably between those two teams. If Winnipeg plays like this, though, I don't count them out against anybody.
Kels, it's funny, when I'm walking around the street, sometimes, I don't know if you know this or not, but like people say, hey, who's the sneaky cool guy at the network? And I go, Mike Kelly. He's the sneaky cool guy. Simple as that.
You lie.
No,
you lie,
I tell
but
truth.
I appreciate it.
I tell truth. I also like to talk about what's going on out west. The Kings, they could punch their ticket to the playoffs with a win over Calgary.
Kings had a chance to clinch in Anaheim Tuesday. Didn't happen. Didn't happen last night because the Blues won their home game.
Grabbing this opportunity. It's there. A chance to get into the playoffs. Don't look what's happening elsewhere on the scoreboard. Take it, grab on, and get into the playoffs. Daniil Mirimanov, a three-sport star back in Russia because, watch this, baseball. Two hands. Use two hands. No problem there. Then football. Ready? There we go. But you can't do that in hockey. He goes to the box. Can you get a chance?
Hands it off. Kopitar to Fiala. Fiala moves in. Shoots. Scores! Kevin Fiala with the power play goal. His team on 11th with the man advantage this season. 1-0 LA.
No question. Markstrom has to look around 33. Looks one way, puck goes the other way. That is almost perfect as far as setup. Move the puck around, get front net presence.
Here's Byfield to the middle with a shot. That's on the stick of Shillington on a play. And then Mahal knocks down Markstrom. I think it's because he was pushed by Kempe, and that draws a reaction. As Markstrom was knocked over by his own defenseman, and then Mahal gets up immediately, goes after Adrian Kempe. So I think we know that might be the smoking gun right there as to how that all happened, Kelly.
Yes, indeed.
Here's Kopitar, a chance. Save is made, and then it bounced back in on goal. Byfield roughing it up with a couple of flames.
Yeah, this will get him involved. You go to those areas, these are going to happen, and that's a good sign.
For Deneau, 1-0 LA. Back to Arvidsson, curl, shoots, and scores! Short side, glove hand, Markstrom. Arvidsson and the Kings are up 2-0. Matt Roy sends it back in down low. Roy, a shot. Score! Might have been tipped by number 41, Thomas. If that's the case, Akil Thomas's third NHL goal in five games. 3-0 LA. Zary gets it back here. Manoff with a shot. Score! Tipped in front by Huberto. The redirection by number 10 gets Calgary on the board and cuts the lead to 2.
And Markstrom is coming over. So again, 3:25. Kings looking for the empty netter.
Hands it off. Sharon Govich feeds it down low. Tipped into the middle, but picked off. Cleared. Score! Bullseye! Victor Arvidsson. And there is the horn. Your 2023-24 LA Kings are playoff bound. Cam Talbot being congratulated by his teammates. It's a 4-1 win.
Yeah, we're happy that we could do that at home too in front of the great fans, and yeah, we grinded all year, so I think we deserve that. Definitely you can feel the vibe, and we have some good feelings out there, and we had some experience the last 2 years. Now it's time to get better, keep our game going as well, keep building. You don't want to get lazy in the last couple of games, so it caught you up in playoffs, so gotta keep going.
Here's what we got now in the West, the playoff picture. The Kings punched their ticket to the postseason for the third consecutive year. That leaves one more spot up for grabs between Vegas and St. Louis. Coming up, two superstars are closing in on some incredible single-season milestones. We'll discuss Austin Matthews chasing 70 goals and Nikita Kucherov staring at 100 assists. It's next. here on the fly. Auston Matthews and the Leafs were in action against the Devils.
Auston Matthews is hunting history. 4 goals in his next 4 games, and he hits the incredible milestone of 70 goals. It's not out of the question the way he scores 4 goals in 4 games. It's a question of how can he do it.
John Tavares up there with Mitch Marner and Bobby McMahon. Here's Tavares moving in. Scores! 18 seconds in, and John Tavares has his 25th of the year.
Good response, and Mercer puts it on. Samsonov rebounds. Free score! Eric Halla! Just 21 seconds later, and we're tied at 1.
Brody sends it into the corner. Knockdown chance. Scores! Auston Matthews, 67. And he's gone past Dave Keon on the all-time Leaf list.
Just 3 away from 70. You give Auston Matthews that kind of chance from that position, and he's done what he's done all year. Put that one in the back of the net.
Deflection.
Turned over to Nolan Foote. Backhand score! Nolan Foote's first in a frustrating, injury-riddled season, and it ties the game.
Leafs have killed 23 of their last 25. Shorthanded.
Rat takes it high slot. He looks for a lane. Meyer, one-timer! He scores! Timo Meier burns his 26th of the year, and the Devils lead.
The talk coming in about are they trying to get him the puck too much, nothing seems forced here. There's just a natural play instead of trying to grab it. He knew he didn't have any time, so tries to put it between the legs and maybe catch Allen on that short side.
Here's Tyler Bertuzzi, back to Domi, takes a look. Bertuzzi scores! 2 of the game, 68 of the year! He's 2 away!
He tried to get it to Bertuzzi, and the end result is it comes right back to him again. Matthews is on the doorstep, and look at that chemistry we've been talking about.
Here's a chance in front, Kemp scores! David Kemp! Leafs scored 2 in a hurry again, and have the lead.
So Devils got a bear down here.
Tied up comes to Meyer, and he rings it in! Timo Meyer off the faceoff win! This game is tied!
Meyer, and he rips it, barring down, to tie it up at 4, his 27th of the season, and his 2nd goal of the night.
Bertuzzi sends it in, Hughes after it, and upended by Matthews. You don't see many of those, and a penalty coming up to 34, past the midway mark of the 3rd.
Hughes steps in, beats Rat, one, timer, score! It's a 3rd power play goal! The Devils lead! 3 power play goals tonight on 4 tries.
Well, this is a big push the last 5 minutes.
He's right in front, Tavares scores! Well, they got back on even terms. John Tavares has 2 tonight.
Bratt through a stick check. He shoots, he scores! Jesper Bratt puts the Devils ahead with 74 seconds to play.
He goes flying through the neutral zone, cuts to the middle, he beats Edmondson on the wall, and look at this wrist shot up top.
New Jersey comes in and steals it with a late goal by Jesper Bratt.
Yeah, I just thought it was a little bit a little sloppy at times, and it just didn't seem like we were as dialed in as we should have been tonight. And obviously playing a team with a lot of speed, a lot of skill, and you know, when you're careless with the puck, obviously they can make you pay. It's obviously, you know, nice to hear those things, but I mean, our season's not done yet, and obviously we're trying to build towards the postseason, so that's really the main focus. And you know, I think these kinds of things are nice to reflect on for a little while, but obviously there's a bigger goal in mind, and so that's kind of where my head's at.
Auston Matthews continues to light the lamp on his quest for 70 goals. He tallied 2 more against the Devils for his 18th multi-goal contest this season, became just the 5th player in the last 35 years to do so. Now on to Tampa, as Nikita Kucherov chases 100 assists.
2 great captains getting set to go head-to-head. You got Steven Stamkos, who is red-hot right now, and the other captain, Brady Tkachuk, leading the way in more ways than one. His next goal is going to tie his career high. Kucherov spins one into the middle of 4 points. Their first shift of the night, points on a dance. He's win! He does! Puts it across! Sherry with a shot and a save by Forsberg. What a play by points, and Connor Sherry comes close.
Rivera. Mark Docker got in the way of that. Now it's brought back for Tkachuk, moving in. Shoot, scores! Brady Tkachuk gives Ottawa the lead. His 35th goal of the year.
Talk about transition. Look at this pass. Right from in front of the net. Tkachuk's got an option, then he goes inside the post.
Point they give to Kucherov. Great pass, backhand and scores! Connor Sherry on another brilliant feed from Nikita Kucherov!
And he spins around, measures it, knows where everybody is, and it's right on the tape to Connor Sherry.
Another milestone hit by Nikita Kucherov. Let's update it. 140 points. Here's Point. One move. Scores! Brandon Point. What a goal! 2-1 to Tampa Bay.
That's number 45. Can he get to 50? Don't bet against him, especially when he's got 86 playing with him. Should have known better than to try and outbox 86.
There's a shot blocked right in front by Mott. He is cut down on that play.
He got that right in the leg, but I mean, he can't get up. I think they're going to call this one now. The gas team. He got it on the skate. Yeah, he can't put any weight on that right foot. Uh-oh.
Another one down. Another shot block on that play, and that shot from Tkachuk. That is Eric Chernak. So for the second time in the last couple of minutes, a member of the Lightning goes down the tunnel after a shot block. Here's Greg. Look out in front for Joseph, and he didn't get a shot away. Two guys all alone. Greg to Joseph. Now stepping in, here's Tkachuk across to Batherson. His shot, another great glove save by Tompkins, who's got a very active glove hand.
Long lead pass for Tkachuk, eluded him. Tkachuk gathers it back up, loose it by Batherson. Oh, and a save by Tompkins, rebound, score! Just after the power play had ended, Drake Batherson strikes his 28th goal of the year. That's a new career high in points for him, and the game is tied at 2.
It's a strong play by Batherson. The Sens have the equalizer here early in the third period.
Lines in for Giroux, back for Matthew Johnson. With a pinch, a point blank, rebound, great. Oh, that was blocked in front by Dumba. He saved a goal. Matt Dumba saves a goal for the Lightning after Joseph is turned away.
We're going to need some overtime. Controls the puck. Here's Kucherov in front. Oh, what a stop by Forsberg. He absolutely robbed points. The shootout is coming up.
This is Tkachuk's first attempt of the year. Scores! Gets his first and gives Ottawa the lead. Stamkos winds in on Forsberg. Hit the goal post! And Ottawa wins it in overtime. Takes 3 of 4 games from the Lightning this year.
But still a major story there. Nikita Kucherov recorded 2 helpers to get to 98 assists, just one shy of Connor McDavid. At Edmonton, plays on Friday, but McDavid missed their game on Wednesday, remains day-to-day with a lower body injury, so Kucherov may have one more shot on Saturday to become the first to 100 assists. Mike, we've had a theme tonight on this show, on the fly. It's all about good journalism. So here's the question, and I think you're going to love it. How good is Nikita Kucherov, huh?
It's unbelievable. You see that spinorama pass he made right in the tape? I mean, this guy, he's incredible. And look, if he's first in your Hart Trophy ballot, if you're a voter, I don't blame you. I think he'd be first on mine. And there's a lot of good contenders. But, man, his ability to find guys and put pucks on their sticks in the most highly of contested areas in so many different ways. He's the best guy in the league on the wall in the power play. And even strength, and we saw what he's doing in this game. It's incredible. And one way to measure playmaking, you look at slot pass completions. How many passes do you complete into the house, the highly contested slot area? He is smoking everybody else in the NHL this season. 359 since our company, Sport Logic, existed in 2015. Nobody's even come close to this number. And this is why he's bumping up against 100 assists this season. I think he gets there. And if he does, we know there's only 3 guys that have ever done it. Connor might do it this year, but even if he does and Cooch does it, that's 5. That's incredible.
All right, let's talk about more incredible then. Auston Matthews now with 68 goals on the season. Put it in perspective what this has meant this season for Matthews.
Well, look, only 8 people have done that, right? So this is a pretty incredible milestone as well if he does get to 70. And even if he doesn't, I mean, he's right there. It's remarkable. The 50 goals at even strength is what really blows me away. And that hasn't been done since the early 90s. I was in Montreal for the game Saturday, Toronto-Montreal at the Bell Centre, and I'm just watching him on his shifts. And he just hangs around the top of the circles. And then the second he sees that a passing lane might open up, he hits that spot, his teammates hit him, and bang, it's in the back of the net because we know how good his shot is. He wants some perspective. This is where he sits on the all-time Maple Leafs goal leaders list, 367 goals. The all-time leader's 420. If Matthews stays healthy and kind of does what he does, you know, the last couple of games this year and next season, at 27 years old, he will probably be the all-time leader in goals for a team that is over 100 years old. That's crazy.
Mike, do you like ice cream?
I love ice cream.
All right, so most people love ice cream, right? And if you ask someone what kind of ice cream you want, they might have one that's a little bit more of their favorite than the other, but ultimately they just love ice cream. So 70 goals, 100 assists. Both feats would be awesome. And it's hard. I'm going to force you to make a choice here. What do you think is the more impressive accomplishment?
I wish I had some ice cream to mull this over right now and think about it because they're both amazing. But you put my feet to the fire. I'm going to say 100 assists. Like, again, it's only been done by three guys, and we know who those three guys are. They're Lemieux, Orr, and Gretzky. That's pretty remarkable company. Now, you can say that scoring goals is the hardest thing to do in the league, and that's true. 100 assists, you got to set guys up, and there's going to be times where those guys don't bury the chances you give them. It's been so infrequent. They're both ridiculous. If I could do one of them, I'd be making 10 sheets a year. Living large, and I wouldn't care which one it was. They're both incredible. So the fact that we're getting to watch it, this has been one of my most fun years watching hockey I can remember with all the crazy stuff that's going on.
Yeah, I'll tell you, watching hockey this season, we've seen so much greatness out there on the ice. I might lean Matthews, the 70 goals just by a hair.
Yeah.
Goals are sexy, man, and that's what we're looking for, right? There you go.
That's why you're on the show, bud.
Hey, thank you. Coming up, the Panthers were on the verge of doing something they've only done one other time in franchise history. More highlights when we return. Welcome back to On the Fly. Results are in from the Frozen Four semifinals. Boston College got a dominant 4-0 win over the University of Michigan, while the University of Denver secured the overtime win against Boston University to advance to the national championship game on Saturday. That means Macklin Celebrini's season at BU is over. Sharks fans hope his next game will be in a San Jose uniform.
Clean Costin. For Henry Thrun, and he scores! All the way from the left point, Henry Thrun's wrist shot goes in, and it's 1-0 Sharks.
It's actually Luke Cunningham who scores the goal for the Sharks, Brett, on this shot by Thrun.
You can see that little deflection by Luke Cunningham there.
Jaden Schwartz drops it off, Eberle. Jordan Eberle now drops it again for Dumoulin, right in, he scores! Brian Dumoulin finds a crack. 10:37 left in period one. The Kraken tie it.
Just a great opportunity. Love seeing the defense getting up and activating the offensive zone.
Eklund gliding ahead to the late man, Burrows, who scores! Kyle Burrows as the Sharks' blue line comes through with a go-ahead goal.
Burrows delivers a strike for the goal.
And now Eklund chipping for Granlund. To the net, they score! It's Fabian Zetterlund. The Sharks with two quick ones. It's 3-1. Eberle draws it off the boards. McCann a shot. Cooley safe. Rebound. What a stop by Devin Cooley off Jaden Schwartz.
Oh, my. Save of the game right there on Schwartz.
And it's over. Cooley and the gang beat the Kraken here in Seattle. A stunning night for Devin Cooley. A great hustle by Bennett, who really had his legs the other night. Now it's Tkachuk. Sending it, and he scores! Tkachuk, ka-ching, 47 seconds in!
Yeah, Checky with a cheese ball right there to open up the scoring. That was a wicked wista.
Matthew Tkachuk goes high on him for his 26th of the season, picked up by Marchenko. He's got Texier in front. He's in! And Bobrovsky with a big stop to keep the Panthers on top.
Texier comes right down through the middle. Bobrovsky at the top of the crease, relies on the reflexes, prevents a goal off the rush.
Getting by Yiricek, Rodriguez,
lost it. Mondale picks it up. Back for Rodriguez. Score! They finally get it by Greaves.
Wow, wasn't the prettiest goal. It looked like it was going to fall apart. But the speed demon, Evan Rodriguez, and sweep it in the back of the net for the Panthers' second goal.
Barkov carries it. Barkov jams it to the net. Has it again below the goal line. Here's Reinhart firing. Score!
He gets himself in the shooting position, and he lights the lamp for his 54th of the season.
Sillinger hustles over to control. Texier fires. Pass save. Severson fires. And Bobrovsky's got that one as well. Sergei slams the door. Panthers continue to just hound in the offensive zone. Forsling shot. Breeds the save, and a Tarasenko with a great effort puts it home.
Great hand-eye coordination by Tarasenko. He knew he was going to get hammered when he went to that front of the net. What a year he's put together.
That is a man's goal right there in the dirty area against a big defenseman in Yurichev. Back-to-back shutouts for Florida. The Rats are flying, and for the second time in franchise history, the Florida Panthers have won 50 games in a season.
Yep, there you go. Just the second time they reached that 50-win marker in franchise history, first being in 21-22 when they won the President's Trophy. Florida hopes that this year's playoffs continues the magic they had just a season ago when they made it to all the way to the Stanley Cup Final. That brings us to the Top Shelf plays of the night.
The give to Kucherov. Great pass. Backhander scores! Another brilliant feed from Nikita Kucherov.
When you play with 86, just get ready. It's coming. Here comes Larkin. Raymond to bring it back, pass right in. Oh, he scores! What a play! Lucas Raymond has two!
And what a move by Raymond.
That last month and a half. Now he's got French. Here's a chance in front. Camp scores! David Camp!
How about those hands? No panic at all. That's a smooth move in front.
Back comes Connor Clifton. 3-on-2 on the entry on this side. Quinn walks it in, holds it, drags it through, scores! Come on, Quinn! That's a beauty, baby.
Quinn pulls. Throughout Denson right there and just lets it rip.
Settles it to Russ. Maybe something here as Russ comes in looking at front. Crosby scores! Throws about a 40-foot saucer pass. Bam! Right onto the stick of Sidney Crosby. And the finish by the captain.
Angles the puck. Slides it for Palmieri.
He scores! The Islanders win it in overtime!
Palmieri goes short side high up into the toy department.
And what a shot it was.
Welcome back to On the Fly. The Women's World Championship semifinals are set. Team USA will look to continue their dominance as they will meet up with Finland in the semifinals, while Canada gets Czechia with hopes to compete for the gold medal once again. Time for the three stars of the night. Our third star is Laurent Brossoit, who stopped all 24 shots faced in the Jets' 3-0 win over the Stars. It was Brossoit's third shutout in his last six games. Jesper Bratt is the second star as he picked up two goals and an assist in the Devils' 6-5 victory over the Leafs. Bratt has reached the 80-point mark on the season for the first time in his career. Star number one at Sidney Crosby collected points. Three of those in the 6-5 overtime win over Detroit. Crosby reached 1,000 assists and moved into 10th place on the all-time points list. What a night it was! And that does it for us, Mike Kelly, and our entire crew here on the fly. I'm Keith Irizarry. We'll catch you next time.
The Stanley Cup playoffs begin in just 10 nights.
Just play and try to enjoy.
Adam Fox, the winner of the Mr. Ranger Award.
This is coming right into your living room. Boom, right there.
Oh! Batting scores! Two of the game, 68 of the year!
Thompson kicks through and ball.